Welcome to 24 Hours Finance. Hope y'all having a blessed day today. In today's video, we're going to be covering some recent news on AMC Entertainment and what this means for us apes. Please smash that like button for the YouTube algorithm and subscribe. Other than that, let's get right into it. We have some news from last weekend that wasn't really published in the mainstream media news. It was very hard to find this news. Although I did find a few articles, most of the articles weren't really reputable article companies, essentially. The only one I could find was from Bloomberg Law, essentially. It's kind of odd that they didn't put this out because obviously they had some type of narrative where they didn't want any good news come up for AMC, obviously. So we're just going to take a look into this news right now because it definitely is good news for us apes. You can see here, this news came out last weekend on a Friday from what it looks like, and it says AMC wins antitrust suit as Texas justice finds no collusion. So it looks like there was a previous lawsuit going on from before, and finally, you know, we finally got the ruling on it essentially, and it looks like AMC is finally off the hook and they don't have to worry about this lawsuit anymore. It mentions here in the article, movie theater chain AMC Entertainment Holdings won an antitrust case brought by IPIC Gold Class Entertainment LLC, alleging AMC had conspired with another movie theater to keep IPIC out of two Texas locations under a ruling from the Supreme Court of Texas on Friday. In a reversal of an appeals court ruling, the state's highest court said that the alleged collusion between AMC and Regal Entertainment Inc. to stop luxury movie theater iPIC from screening first-run movies into Houston and Frisco was implausible. So that means there literally was not really any evidence or not really any proof or anything in regards to, you know, give some slight of reasoning of that there was actually some collusion going on, you know, so they definitely threw it out. So under the Texas Antitrust Act and federal law, IPIC's argument can't survive summary judgment because it rests only on parallel conduct and suspicion, as the court says. And the court's opinion was unanimous, and Justin Evan Young did not participate in the decision. And the rest of the information there isn't really too relevant. Main thing here is that AMC definitely won this case here, and there's no collusion, so it looks like that's all in the past now. Moving forward, I did find some news from last week as well that it looks like AMC wants to turn its movie theaters into virtual concert venues, essentially. And you can see here in this article, with dozens of artists pivoting to livestream concerts since 2020, virtual concert platform Amaze VR announced Tuesday, January 11th, in a press release that it had closed on a $15 million bridge funding round ahead of plans to outfit AMC movie theaters with its suite of experiential virtual reality VR tech, turning them into small concert halls, essentially. So looking into Amaze VR's website, you can see here that they mentioned that they're looking to be the next stage of music. Through VR concerts, Amaze VR brings fans closer to artists like never before. Come face to face with your favorite artists with crystal clarity and unprecedented proximity through live action 3D footage. Feel their gaze, follow their moves. Combined with CG rendered environments, you can experience VR concerts in fantastical new worlds for the very first time. And they also mentioned Amaze VR is at the forefront of the next great shift in technology to usher in the next stage of music, which is obviously great to hear. And it's going to be coming to theaters near you, which would be including AMC Entertainment, essentially. And Amaze VR is partnering with movie theaters around the world to transform traditional auditoriums into VR concert venues. Theaters will be outfitted with state-of-the-art VR headsets for total immersion while leveraging surround sound audio for breathtaking realism. Guests will have a seamless transition from the physical to virtual worlds as they interact with each other as virtual avatars from a truly shared VR concert experience. So definitely you can see here all the funding that they've had. There's more information on the website here. So definitely go and take a look yourself if you like. I just wanted to bring your attention to the website and what they actually do. And very shortly right now, I'm going to be playing a quick clip for you in terms of how the Amaze VR works. And this is actually one of their demos that they put out recently in terms of promotion. So let's get right to that. after watching that video, it looks like, you know, this new technology looks very promising and it could be very good for AMC in the long term in terms of fundamentals. We won't know for sure until later in the long term when it's fully adopted and we can see how it executes. But coming back to this article over here, we're just going to take a look into some few points of the article here where it does make things seem to make a lot more sense essentially, and why this may play out for AMC in terms of the type of environment we're actually trying to position ourselves into in terms of the metaverse, NFTs, things like that. So as it mentions here, taking the wraps off its plans last summer, Amaze VR announced a pack with AMC, Roc Nation, which is from Jay-Z's label essentially, and Grammy Award winning artist Megan Thee Stallion for an immersive virtual concert experience achieved by outfitting movie theaters with VR tech that recreates the real thing. I also believe Megan Thee Stallion is still under Roc Nation's label for her management services essentially. So, I mean, in turn, if she actually, you know, gets a big hit off of this or does really well for her, Jay-Z obviously may be looking in terms of his other artists in Roc Nation in terms of following suit with this type of technology and this type of pursuit into this business essentially. The article also mentions the first ever VR concert tour springs from years of R&D that resulted in proprietary 9K cameras and in software that can automate complex Unreal Engine-based visual effects and run more than 100 headsets at a time. And using this technology, the company plans to scale its content creation, releasing new VR concert experiences weekly by 2024 to both in-theater and at-home viewers. The CEO of Amaze VR also mentions that the new bridge funding puts us in an ideal position to take full advantage of VR and the metaverse's growing popularity as we deliver breathtaking VR concerts from major artists, first to theaters, then to homes worldwide. This new direction in virtual events follows other recent efforts along the same lines, namely the Fortnite virtual concert series that featured superstars including Travis Scott, Ariana Grande, and others, and the musical duo 21 Pilots stage a virtual concert in Roblox as well. From my experience, I did actually witness one of the VR events in terms of the virtual concert of Travis Scott on Fortnite, and I can say that was definitely a very entertaining concert that he had, and lots of people were tuned in for that. So it actually does look like a lot of the entertainment music business is starting to slowly head over to the metaverse and VR side of the business, because there's definitely a larger platform there and a lot more room to grow. And it looks like, you know, most millennials and the Gen Zs essentially, they've already grown accustomed to this gaming entertainment type of lifestyle, especially in the virtual world. So it definitely looks like a place that AMC wants to be if you're looking to obviously stay in the loop. On another note, I just wanted to let y'all apes know to be careful and be sure to do your own due diligence before making any financial decisions based off news and media that you see. The fake news and shills are starting to get worse, as you might have seen Fox Business playing dirty recently, running ads on multiple social platforms saying AMC was going to go private, which obviously that would never happen. But other than that, enjoy the rest of your day. Please smash that like and subscribe button if you enjoy this content. And peace out. I get it.